What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Crossout. This looks very familiar, right? Well, it's not exactly the same as the drone build because what I did actually was install a turret. We're going to be testing out the turret today. The turret deployer with a 440 power score basically drops a turret and the thing has an MG and it rips things apart. And so we're going to be checking that out today and see what this thing's all about. The drone proved to be very, very useful and very successful, and if you guys didn't see that, I think it was Wednesday's video, so you go back and watch it if you didn't see it. But this is the same build. I just put the turret in there and fits perfectly, and the power score is actually a little bit lower, and so that's kind of nice. And so you don't have to see me build anything in today's video or anything like that. This is what it is. So basically it's hidden and it just kind of pops out behind you, and then look at that damage it does. Look at that damage. So anything that comes close to this thing is going to get ripped apart. Now, you can't shoot it. You know, you could shoot it. And it's gone. And it has a, you know, then the cooldown starts once it's gone. And so you are pretty much without anything until that, just the guns that you have until the turret comes back up. So that's what we're going to be checking out in today's video. Remember to thumbs up if you like the video, like the series. Let me know if you guys want to see more, if you have any cool build ideas, and then subscribe if you're new to the channel. And let's just get right into it, right? Why waste any more time? Okay, bridge could be pretty good. We have got a couple spots initially that we could put it down and actually probably do quite a bit of damage. We've got AI coming right here, but I was thinking more so down in this area overlooking that lower part there. We got a couple people, I believe, with pyro launchers, so we need to look out for those things. God, she just got freaking annihilated, David. Dude, they are all coming over here quick. I think there must be a time limit on the turret. I'm guessing that's what it is. Because I don't think they're getting destroyed. I think it's a time limit. This guy's gonna get annihilated. Can we focus fire the wheels? There we go. This guy's incapacitated as the turret just hammers. Oh my gosh, you are smoked, dude. Come on, hit the cab. There we go. So we got Sarah, we got a couple other people, a couple other guys down here. He's trying to focus fire the wheels. There, nice. Wow, I somehow got that kill. Guy snuck around behind. I'm taking like no damage. We actually have quite a bit of HP with this build. It's kind of nice. So I'm just going to swarm in, drop the turret, and then just keep moving. Turret should hit him right there. Nope, it didn't. We got him though. We got three kills, but we didn't really use the turret at all. Dang, that sucked. We just missed like hitting with that turret there at the end. But I think it's gonna be pretty good. Okay, we're on this map, which is probably the best one for the turret, I think. And I should say, like, I don't personally like this build. And I don't think it's very good. That's my opinion, you know, obviously. But I'm not a big fan of it, simply because it's not moving around like a drone is. It's just sitting there, and so you can easily shoot it a little bit. It doesn't have enough HP. So maybe if they made it have more HP, then it could be, then it might be a little bit more effective. Or maybe let you put down, like, let you equip more than one. That could be something kind of cool. You have multiple turrets. But I think simply because of the fact that it's just sitting there, the turret has, I think, probably just as much HP as the drone has. And since the turret is not moving, it's not as good as the drone is. That's just my personal opinion, but I think that there's some, like, good thoughts behind that. And the thing is, too, is that the AI just hone in on them so much, so easily. They're like, the entire team's in there in the middle, so I'm not going in there, screw that. I'm gonna try to snipe them from this ridge line. where the rest of our team is. But we do have to go in, though, or they're going to cap it. But now we're with our team, at least. Well, one guy. Don't focus on the AI. Just keep moving. Okay, good. The AI is, like, pathfinding is so bad, but they're, like, shooting is good when it comes to other AI. But when it comes to other players, it's not as good. Just light them up. This situation right here is about the only one that I think makes it any good. I'm gonna try to assault this guy from the side. Got him. Nice. So just Olivia's left. And she's down there doing who knows what. So that wasn't too bad. That wasn't too bad. That was actually pretty good. We got 4 kills. That turned out a lot better than it ever has so far. We 1600 HP, XP. Pretty good. That was a pretty good match. All right. Power plant could be good or bad, really. It's kind of up in the air. Simply because if your team doesn't like kind of go together, it could be an issue. I'm gonna follow all these guys. I'm gonna follow the radio build guy. I don't know why people think this build's very good. You have no HP by the time you slap all that on, and your power score is pretty high. Okay, we got one guy coming. Goods drawn. Come on, turret. Yeah, look at those hits. The more he moves back, the... Oh, my gosh. Everyone found us. Oh, I'm going to get destroyed here. Please, teammates, say you know that these people are here. Oh, those cannons. Oh, those cannons. Nice. Turreted cannon, too. Whew. Man, those cannons hit hard. Thank you, teammates, coming to my rescue. I cannot turn at all. My nose is down and I am incapacitated. That's all she wrote for me. Do work, little turret. Do work. All right, so the thing with this build, I think, is going to be dependent on the map you play, because you could definitely find a good spot for the turret that overlooks a lot of, like, a wide area, and it's probably going to be the best for doing damage there. But, you know, I don't really know where to go or what to do. Actually, we're on this side. I actually do know a good location I think this thing would be pretty good in, right up this hill over here. And so if I can come up here and deploy it up there, it might be able to shoot everything that comes over this way. That is the hope, at least. And so I do need to get it somewhat close. Here we go, Nicholas. Sweet! That was awesome. It spun around like that. That's great. Come on, turret, kill Nicholas over here. There we go, look at those hits. Okay, the turret's down. Just like drop it out over the edge. Oh crap. There's a guy with a pyro launcher on this, in this match. And so I definitely should probably be aware of that. We're getting out of dodge, man. People coming back here. Yeah, there. Oh, it's Nicholas again. Freaking Nicholas. Dude, the AI have it out for me, I swear. How much health does he have? He's got medium machine guns. Screw that, man. It's so unfair. The AI is so unfair. Get. They do so much damage. The medium machine guns and the 25... AI is just stupid OP at this battle rating. Battle rating, power score. Battle rating. Alright, come on. Show yourself. Does it have a time limit or what? It must have a time limit. He's not gonna see the turret till it's too late. It's doing so much damage. Look at that damage. Oh no, I'm dead. Dang it, man. Shoot. Okay, Founder's Canyon might be probably one of the worst maps for this thing, I think, because it's a pretty close range. There's only a couple spots. Look at these walkways right here. That's so cool. There's only a couple spots you can really go to be effective. But most of it is like, you know, you got the center. You got these like big things you can go around, and that's pretty much it. Some of the spots on the center. If I put that turret down right there, will that shoot? Or is that too far away? I think it's too far away. Oh, it's hitting. Oh, it's hitting Alec. Tear it up, turret. Turret's gone. Nice kill assist. Okay, not too bad, not too bad. Killed Alec. Where is the rest of their team, though? They must have went around the other way, so that means that there might be some people in the middle. That also means the majority of them are probably going to our base. There's only two of them that have died so far. I think ideally what you want to do is like kind of actually protect the turret. Get into a spot where the turret can be effective and just kind of sit there and protect it. There's a guy. Drive by him and drop the turret. Irish bangs. Oh crap. Too many MGs. And there's another guy. Who hit me with the cannon? Oh, from the hilltop. Crap. I didn't see that guy up there. I didn't actually even see that guy right there. Oh, he's got a sight up there. Okay, we got two guys left. This is not looking good. This is not looking good. Oh my gosh. That guy got annihilated. Brian, there's no way you can win this match first, man. It is all over. That is the game. Match, set, point. It's over. Your 20 can't do anything. You're gonna get annihilated. Hey, that's like one of the first times I've seen the AI actually lock on that well. Run Nation's got a lot of MGs. Devastating those MGs. It's over. It's power playing time. The more and more I use the turret build, the less I like it. The drone was a little bit more like deliberate attacking. The turret is a lot of, you pretty much just kind of try to get a good setup and then wait for people to come. It's very dependent on the map. That is for sure. It's definitely not as easy to use. Because the drone is up in the air and, you know, they have to like try to shoot it down, whereas like the turret is like just standing still essentially, and so it's a little bit easier to kind of shoot it down. See, like that right there, that was an AI that just shot that down extremely easily. And so then you just rely on your MGs that you have, and you know, I only have two of them, and so they get shot off really easily. And it's just, I don't know, for the power score that it has, it's just, it seems like it's a little too much. I would almost lower the turret power score. Seems crazy. The AI just hone in on the turret so easily too. Yeah, this, I don't know, this, I'm not a big fan of this build. It's not as easy to use the drone. Drop the turret, it hits a little bit, it can easily be shot and taken out. It's just not nearly as good as the drone. I can see why it's a little less power score. But I mean, overall, it's just I'm not a big fan of the turret. Maybe some people are. Maybe the missile one's way better, but the regular MG one's not that great. All right, Rock City, we're on the good side. I like this side because you get to usually go up around this. I don't even know if you can see the cursor. This back center hill over here across from the neutral base, and it's a pretty good spot to sit and kind of shoot people up. And I think it's probably one of the best spots for the turret to be the most effective. Alternatively, we could go the right side, and there's like one spot you can kind of camp from. Not really camp, you just kind of see the majority of the map. And then also right here, there's a nice little lookout that a lot of people sit that use pyro launchers on this type on this map. It's a super OP. How is someone there? Is that AI? Right here. It's a super OP spot for those things. You can see the entire map. All the lookout spots and everything. It's just nuts. Alright, so as long as nobody comes behind us, we should be okay. A very good chance someone will, though. I hope I put that down to where it can still shoot. We'll find out the hard way, probably. I don't think you can, though. Wow, what the heck? Shots are missing like crazy. This is... That guy's got a big gun. More than likely. Nice, we came around the flank behind. Guy's dead. Let's go in center cap. Drop the turret down and see what we can do up here. There's a guy up there. He's got pyro launchers. Nice. That's a good spot, I think. Yes. Okay, good. It's hitting. Let's not block the shots of the thing, though. Jeez, our team just wrecked those guys. Okay, this guy doesn't have pyro launchers. I just saw a guy that had this look of a build earlier. What's he got? Cannon mounted up high or something? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, he ain't getting away that easily.
Don't flip over. Dang it! I wanted to kill that guy. Well. I gotta be more specific with the placement of the turret. I could have easily shot those guys in the center cap if I would have not placed it by that hill the way I did. All right, here we go. Okay, let's do this. It's the medium machine guns at this power score to just tear you apart. I just wish that I wish the turret had a little bit more HP. I could see it being really good if it had a little bit more HP. Didn't get killed as easily. Anyone over here? Nope, but there could be somebody back here sniping. But by the looks of it, I don't think there is. I think they all went the other way. Nope. We're capping the enemy base. Take those points down, make them come back to us. And they're overlooking the area though. One guy is, though, at least. Let's not get stuck on the wall, please. Turret's just ripping that guy apart. That was not bad at all. Not bad at all. The turret just went down. I can just jack this guy up. Took out his wheel. Ha! Sucker! Let's go back to our base. They're capping it. It's just me and the entire enemy team left. My team sucks, man. Holy smokes. Why did everyone get... I think because they all went together as a team is the likely answer there. Come on. Kill this guy. Just let me get one more kill. It's really all I care about at this point. Since everyone else is dead. Come on! Come on! Oh, it's over. It's all she wrote. That's all she wrote. The entire enemy team just annihilated our team. Made it look so easily. So easy. Did I say so easily? Made it look so easily, guys. I know English, don't you know?
It's over. It's over.
Well, you guys will have to let me know what you guys think of this build. What do you think of the turret specifically? This is the exact same build as I used for the drone. And I feel like the drone was way more effective because it was in the air, moving around constantly. Whereas the turret, you just drop it and kind of move on. And I don't know. I don't really like it that much. It's my personal opinion. You guys will have to let me know what you think. Thumbs up if you liked the video. Subscribe if you're new. I'll see you guys in the next one.